Pardon the mess here, everyone, but today we're going to be talking about fitting shafts, specifically 3D printed shafts, into bearings. So the two main things we're going to cover is the design and how you print it, and also a tip to secure the bearing onto the shaft. And by the way, this video is sponsored by PCBWay. More about them at the end of the video. So first of all, when you're 3D printing shafts, specifically shafts that will take a little bit of load, you do not want to 3D print them vertically. So you'll see that if you 3D print them vertically, they can snap really easily along the layer lines. You can see this is a broken piece and that's the rectilinear infill. So we got a shaft and the first thing you think is, okay, the shape of the bearing is a circle. So I'm gonna simply create a circle and extrude it. Well, after you 3D print it, and it doesn't matter whether you use supports or not, it's gonna be very hard to fit. You can see this is supposed to fit all the way in, and it's really hard to push it in, and it's not going all the way down. This is because, and it's very hard to get out. I'm using full force. All right, and that's because you can see that this overhang causes imprecise tolerances by the 3D printer. You can see it kind of bulges out a little bit because 3D prints can't 3D print on thin air, thus causing an imprecise tolerance, which won't let things fit. So the easiest workaround is simply just cut two slots out. You can see the top is flat and the bottom is also flat. Now, a good formula for this is to cut out, so the remaining distance from the top to bottom should be 5/8 of the diameter of this the total height prior to cutting out. So that's my sweet spot, but you should play around. Depending on your 3D printer, it might be different. So now you can see when I press it in, it fits perfectly, and you can see the inside sits stable, sits stationary, while the outside rotates freely. And this amount of friction is perfect. So it's not like sliding around or anything, nor was it terribly hard to press the bearing in. Now let's talk about fixing the bearing in place. Okay, so before we talk about that, I just want to show you guys a real world demonstration of this. See, this, and this is almost like a sneak peek, is my semi, or pretty much fully 3D printed material shaft. And it uses sets of bearings. And at first, with these perfectly circular shafts, these chunky bearings took a lot of effort to fit on. You can see it's like, it's quite hard to slide on, and taking it off takes some effort. Now the second iteration, which I have already installed, and don't mind the shaft collars, they're in the way, but we'll get to them in a minute. You can see that the bottom of it is flat. I'll use probably this tool. So this is just a perfectly flat tool. You can see how it lines up really well. So the bottom is flat, the top of the shaft is also flat. And now look at how easy it is to slide it on. Boom. And see how the outside rotates freely while the inside stays stationary with just the right amount of friction. Now let me ask you, how do we keep this bearing in place? Because first of all, over time the friction might wear out, and then this entire thing, including the inner ring, might start rotating. And second of all, we don't want this bearing to slide back and forth, because again, the friction might wear out, and you can't rely on that, especially for high stress applications. This is where these shaft collars come in. So essentially, shaft collars are circular clamps that clamp down onto the shaft, and they keep the shaft and bearing in place. Now the other side I covered up because there's gears here and I'm too lazy to disassemble it. So you can just imagine, well, if I can see, I'm trying to pull this and it barely moves. There's a little bit of tolerance because I didn't clamp, like push it all the way in right. So you might see a little bit of jittering, but in general, the bearing stays pretty stable. Now there's two types I want to cover today, and the two main types that I'll use are basically dual split bearings, like so, And then, dual split shaft collars. So it's two pieces, and there's essentially two screws you have to use. And this is a 3D printed part. Okay, so just to demonstrate, so if I completely release one end, you guys can see that it opens up pretty wide, and then when you release the other end, it just disassembles itself. And then there's the single slit, whatever you call it. I'm not very good with names, but essentially this shaft collar is pretty much an entire donut and just has one cut in it. And sometimes it has a little slit right here to help the material flex. So the way this type of shaft collar works is there's either a set screw, or in my case, it uses the clamping action to secure it. There's a screw that tightens and brings these two ends, pinches it together. And that's how it pinches down onto the shaft. And if you couldn't tell, these are made out of 3D printed aluminum. And that brings me to the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. Plastic shaft collars are fine for light loads, but for high stress, I needed something tougher. PCBWay helped me metal 3D print these collars in aluminum using SLM 3D printing. A laser fuses fine metal powder layer by layer into a solid part. I sent them my parametric fusion design, chose aluminum ALSI-10MG, and a few days later, the collars arrived. They're light, incredibly strong, and I can tighten the set screw without cracking or deforming them. If you want custom, durable collars without a full machine shop, metal 3D printing through PCBWay is the way to go. Check them out with the link in the description. We covered a good amount in this video, from 3D printing the shafts to securing the bearings in place. Now you know how to 3D print and 3D model for using bearings that allow models to spin freely. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, I would appreciate if you liked and subscribed, and maybe drop a comment down below to let me know how I can improve these videos. Alright, that's all I have for you guys today. I'll catch you guys in the next one.